in your email queries, do you see one mistake all the time?
I see a lot of mistakes, and maybe we should just chat about a few of those. You have to grab me very quickly, or any agent quickly.
First sentence.
First sentence has to be, I would work on that over and over and over. Mm-hmm. Grab me by the throat and say, read my email. A lot of people start talking, my name or my manuscript is 69,123
right.
words.
Boring.
Boring, deadly boring. Try to make a connection and immediately.
Yeah.
So that's something.
And also what you have in here is bad examples and good examples. I thought that was very helpful.
Yeah. I hate to teach bad things, but sometimes we're all guilty. And if
I read them all thinking, ooh, have I written one like this? I didn't want to see my...
Exactly. And a key thing in the beginning is to make that connection. I bought your book, or I met you at a conference, or... I write just like an author of yours.
Something personal that says the author knows who you are.
They've done their homework. It says a lot very quickly.
Yes. Are there common traits in the authors that you represent who've been successful either in getting a representation or going on in their career? Are there common traits?
There are a lot of them. The authors that I love are doing their life's work. Mm-hmm. You know, many of them are helping people with their retirement plans or helping kids with allergies or, you know, they're doing their life's work and they have a lot to say in that space. I find it tough when people come to me and they say, I can write about anything.
That's no good.
No. I call that shoe shopping. What's in your heart? What do you want to write about?
Yeah. And also that doesn't work anymore for authors, because when you're building a platform, your platform has to be about who you are as a writer. It can't be about every different thing that's popular at the moment.
That's absolutely right.
Yeah.
And you, Tessa, you just stole the word right out of my mouth. I was going to say, nope, perfect. I was going to say, it's so key that people have a platform these days. Publishers want to know, how are you going to reach your audience?
Okay, so let's be specific here. What numbers are we talking about? Like, how many Facebook likes, how many Twitter likes, followers?
It's hard to say because it depends on the category. But I find, for example, at McGraw-Hill, if I'm selling a business book there, they want people to have 40,000 names, that kind of threshold, whether it's a newsletter or...
Anywhere. So it could be email, or it could be followers, or it could be likes. 40,000, that's a lot.
That's a lot. That's one example.
Okay.